Morgan Cooper tonight continue to develop coming off Tommy John surgery. It takes a while, not even just one or two starts. It might take a few more starts, so continue to develop in this start tonight. Limit your pitch count. If you want to stay in the game, you want to get a win possibly, limit that pitch count early in the game and get that first hitter. Bryce Johnson for these Bearcats, leading hitter. He's got 21 hits on the season, a very good ball player, and it all starts with the leadoff guy.
Yeah, and the leadoff guy in an inning limits your pitch count too as well, Greg. When you look at what Morgan does on a night here that we weren't sure earlier, we moved up an hour early just because of the weather and the possibility of weather in the future. These two teams have played an awful lot over the course of the years. I remember playing them when I was in school here a long time ago. This is the 93rd, 94th meeting. The one meeting not here in Austin took place in a regional down at Rice a few years ago, and the Bearcats came away with a victory in that ball game.
That was a good, hard-fought game. Anytime you're in the postseason, both teams want to win. I remember that game. Very good ball game. Bearcats came out on top.
So Morgan Cooper will lead it off against Bryce Johnson. Greg told you a little bit about him. He is a good-looking young hitter. He's from Cypress, Texas, and he's a sophomore.
Good size. 6'2", 180. Center fielder.
We're underway. The best thing that could happen to a team is to come right back and play. You had a day off, as you mentioned yesterday, and after Sunday, and just try to get that taste out of your mouth and go forward and say, hey, this is a new day.
Yeah, there are times in a major league season, and probably a few times in a major league season, where you just get completely away from the game. I mean, you're not playing well, you're losing. Texas had a rough weekend. Get away from that for a day and come back recharged tonight.
Go to class yesterday, go get something to eat, and not think about baseball.
Try not to think about baseball.
Well, it's easier said than done, isn't it? The 2-1. Good bunt up the third baseline. And Clemens does a nice job letting that ball roll as he understood he was not going to get an out either way. And that's the first time we've really seen it go that far. I thought that ball was going to stay fair that time.
It was bunted slow enough down that third baseline where normally this ball will stop in fair territory, but right there it just takes a left turn. Cody, knowing the speed of Johnson, he did not pick that ball up and try to throw it. Let it roll foul.
The 2-2. Just stays upstairs. He had him fooled with the breaking ball there. Just didn't get the call from Jerry Johnson, the home plate umpire.
He's up slightly.
Now Matt McHenry at first, David Wiley at second, John Bible, the umpire at third. The payoff. Hit pretty well up the middle by a diving Baker into center. We talked about Johnson being a good offensive player and shows it right there. That was a good solid at bat. Six-pitch at bat start the ball game.
That's what you want out of your leadoff hitter. We saw the curveball. We saw the changeup. Saw the fastball. Players for the Bearcats sit over there and can watch every pitch. That looked like it could have been a hanging changeup. 3-2.
Good execution as the hitter front side down. Got on top of it. Riley McKnight squares. Pulls the bat back. McKnight, a freshman from spring.
Good speed by Johnson, 5 for 6 on stolen bases this year.
The Bearcats 12-19 as a team, so they will be aggressive on the base pass. This is again downstairs. Almost looked like his body, he was trying to go field his position before he finished the pitch.
Yeah, sometimes you know a bunt's coming, so you try so hard to throw a strike and you know you have to field that position. Morgan just needs to relax. They're trying to give you an out right here.
Nice bunt up the first baseline. And a nice job by Cooper to come over underhand. Clements. Good execution on everybody's part. Runner into scoring position.
That was a good bunt by Riley McKnight right up the first baseline. Morgan Cooper, all 6'4 of him, has to get over there and field it and flip it all in one motion. Did a good job. Tress goes out and gives him a little breather.
Probably just a little bit of a review, too, to say, all right, second sign.
Right.
Just to remind Cooper exactly what sign they're going to use with the runner in scoring position. Zach Smith steps in. He's a senior from Cypress. Had a fantastic start. You see the numbers there. 372. 16 base hits already on the season. Rip to right. Johnson had to hold, Greg, because of the line drive. Dive back to first. Smith almost took too big a turn. That's one of those line drives as a runner where you're not sure if it's going to be in there or not.
It was just high enough for Casey not to get to it, just low enough to have to stay at first. So Casey in cutoff. There for the cutoff. Goes over. Just gets to the runner. A little bit late.
Hunter Hearn will step in. Breaking ball, throw down to second. They got the runner hung up. No, he didn't. Just thrown out. How about that? Smith. I thought they were running a little play right there because he did not get a great jump from first base.
Didn't get a good jump, and Hearn swung at the pitch. I don't know if it's a runner on first and third hit and run here or what happened. A good throw, a good tag, and Johnson remains at third base.
Big out. 2-4 on the put out. Over the top of a breaking ball. Cooper a pitch away from getting out of a jam here.
You don't have to be too fine right here. Got a freshman up. Got a runner in scoring position. Got two strikes on him. He's already swung a two in the dirt.
Three. Rare blocks it out in front, and Cooper pitches out of it. He gives up two hits, has runners at first and third, but comes back with a big strikeout to get out of it. In his 20th season as the head coach here at the University of Texas, Augie Garrido, you can see the number of wins, second most in school history, 48th year overall, and I guarantee you, as you read some of the quotes and being around Coach Garrido, Sunday was a tough one for everybody, including him. It was one of those games where you just look at it and say, how did that slip away? But his lineup looks like this tonight. The first thing that jumps off the page to me, Greg, is Patrick Mathis back in the lineup. Not out in the field, but at least healthy enough to be the DH.
We saw Patrick come off the bench Sunday, get a 0-2 base hit. So a big, could be just a confidence for the lineup and a little pick-me-up. See Patrick back in that lineup. He does have two home runs this year.
They're going to face a junior transfer and right-hander Cody Brown. When you look at him, 6'2", 190-pound junior. And, you know, you look at this, is this an opportunity for Brown to get deep into this game? Because the thing that jumps off the page to me is he's walked 10 batters in just over 7 innings of work.
He's had a little command problem this year. Walking quite a few right there in 7 2/3 innings. He comes from Tyler Junior College, back-to-back Junior College World Champs. See the scouting report. Try to go 5. It's just a second start. And how do you do that? You limit your walks, which means you limit your pitches and control your motions. It's a big game for him here in Austin, a big game for the Bearcats.
Who quickly falls behind Travis Jones, 2 balls and no strikes. Travis, a sophomore from Humble, off to a good start. Hitting 450 as he steps in right here. Limited duty. 2-0 changeup, misses outside. 4 outside the zone. Good start for Texas. Greg, if you start your year, and I know it didn't happen to you, but you've helped a lot of pitchers. If you start your year and you're really struggling with your release point and your command, what are some of the things that a young man like Cody Brown can do to help find the strike zone?
Well, I think a lot of it just starts with playing catch. You play catch and you have your throwing partner just put his glove up and you try to hit the mitt, try to hit the glove. And then also by repeating mechanics. Repeating your mechanics on the mound is one of the easiest way to find the release point and find the target.
This ball gets away. Back to the screen. Cannon behind the plate. We'll see what they call that. Boy, a real opportunity, Texas, to play with a lead. See if they call it a pass ball or a wild pitch.
Hit off his glove. I think it crossed him up is what happened, but it was off the mitt. He set up. Looks like he might have been setting up for the breaking ball. Got the fastball.
Goes as a pass ball. Boswell probably swinging the bat now. The 1-1. Fouled off. Out of play left side. You mentioned in the open, Greg. Get a guy on second, nobody out. You got to get him over. You got to move runners. When you're struggling to score runs, you got to get this guy over and get this guy in.
A couple times over the weekend, Texas unable to do that.
Brown set. Popped him up. Foul territory down the left field line. That's a nice play right there. Come over and make the play by Smith. Found the wall, Greg, and able to make the play.
We found the wall and found the security guard down there in the stool. You see right here, he has to find the security guard there. He just didn't know. Keeping his eye on the ball the whole time.
That brings Joe Baker to the plate. Sophomore from McKinney. Smile right there by the security guard. You know, you almost got to pick that chair up and try to run away from the ball, don't you?
It's home field advantage.
Should be. Baker had a good weekend against Cal. He's been very consistent offensively. Off of his hands, runner was going. Jones could have a double play back to second in time. Jones was trying to steal third. Baker popped it up. And a 5-3 double play. Ends the inning, trying to get something going, trying to force the action a little bit, and it costs Texas as the ball up in the air. Right there, nice fake. Get the double play.
Well, Taylor Bean, the third baseman for the Sam Houston Bearcats, really set up this play right here. See the swing by Joe Baker. It's up, and you saw Bean go down and act like he was going to field the ball. Made Travis Jones hold up. Travis unable to see the pop-up. You'll see Travis. He's looking for the bag the whole time. There he looks up for the ball right there, but Bean did a good job of deking him. Travis took about 5 more steps and unable to get back for the double play.
And Texas again with a runner in scoring position with nobody out, unable to score. Nothing game as we go to the top of the second. Morgan Cooper out for his second inning of work. He pitched out of a jam. He had runners at first and third. Herrera threw out a runner trying to steal. Smith trying to steal second. Struck out Hearn. So it'll be Jordan Cannon to lead it off. Freshman from Centerville, Texas.
Right up on the dish.
And his hands way up in the air.
These boys throw out some Sadaharo leg kicks up there.
I'm telling you, they get up and take. Coach Diggs told us, hey, I'm gonna have some young guys and they're gonna let it go. They're gonna get up there and let it go. And
look at this.
I mean, big leg kick, front side down, and throwing the bat in. Breaking ball, pull, foul.
See, I'm thinking with that big leg kick, the breaking ball might be easier to hit. Because if you're not, I mean, you're going to be not catching up with the fastball, in my opinion. A good fastball up and in.
The 0-2. Cooper tried it, missed over the plate.
So those leg kicks, it's all about timing.
The 1-2. Kept it alive on a breaking ball.
The fastball was a good idea, 0-2, but needs to be over the plate and just above the hands of Cannon. Throws him on a curveball.
Second strikeout for Cooper.
He's just guessing. If you're Cannon, he's got the leg kick, the leg's down. A good curveball in the outer half.
You know, if you got that big a leg kick, it's, sometimes it may be difficult to recognize.
And he's got the mask on.
Purcellin, Barrett, Huntsville, Texas, native. And he takes a good hack.
That's the fastball I'm talking about right there. Morgan has a good enough fastball to throw it in that location. Get a lot of swing and misses, especially after that curveball. He's gonna try it again.
A lot more comfortable, at least at his mound presence and his comfort. He's a lot more comfortable here in the second than he did in the first.
First inning, he had to worry about runners on base the whole time. That could make you uncomfortable. I like to go out there and early in ball games and not have to worry about that. Well, Johnson led off with the base hit. Make you slow things down.
Has not had great command of his change, and we haven't seen it very often, but he's been good with his fastball curveball to this point.
You saw the change to the leadoff hitter. He hung it, got it hit. Sometimes you'll shy away from it. And he has real good command of that curveball. Like that.
Three consecutive strikeouts. Selman down on strikes. Just freezes it.
This is almost old-fashioned. 12-6 right there.
Josh Biles will step in. Another true freshman from Sugar Land. A lot of young guys on this Sam Houston State club.
29 newcomers on this team this year.
Said that, you know, we're young, but we're physical, we're big, we're strong, we got some good speed. He's looking forward. He said he likes this group, but they are young. On the ground to third, Clements across to his older brother. 1-2-3 go the Bearcats here in the second. 0-0 game. Glad you're with us. Started about an hour early if you were looking at some of the reports around. We're supposed to start at 7:00 Central, but rain expected and major storms here in the Central Texas area at some point tonight. Decided to move it up 1 hour to get the ball game in. Sam Houston got here, said they didn't run into a lot of traffic and ran into some rain to about 90 miles east of here. They're in and trying to get this thing going. 0-0 game here, bottom of the second. Keith Mullen, Greg Swindell with you. Both teams have had opportunities. Neither team able to cash one in at this point. Brown out for his second inning work as Barrera steps in.
There's other ways you can find release points, like in between starts when you throw your bullpen. just throw nice and easy. Throw 50%. And then gradually start throwing harder. You got baby steps. So right now, the first inning, first six pitches were balls, and now the first two in the second inning.
And are all in the same spot. That's the part. Now, if you were, you know, missing up and in, down and in, low and away, you know, but everything seems to be away, 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 and missing away. The 3-0. Gets the call in the corner. And another leadoff walk. Second inning in a row, Texas with a leadoff base runner. Casey Clemens will stride to the plate. Casey, along with Joe Baker, two offensive players that really had a good weekend over the weekend. Team didn't have one. But both Joe and Casey swung the bat quite well over the weekend. The 6'1", 215-pound junior from Memorial High School in Houston. Squares to bunt. Pitch misses upstairs. Brown continues to struggle with command.
Texas needs to take advantage of that. You have a pitcher struggling on the mound. You're struggling to score runs. You have to do everything possible to get runs across.
Squares again. Pitch misses again.
It's the same thing. Four wide ones. Now you're 2-0. Brett tried to bunt once, and then they let him swing away after that. I would think Casey might continue to bunt right here.
Seven pitches in the inning, six outside the zone. And here comes the 2-0. Good bunt up the first baseline. Brown over to Biles for the first out. Good execution by Texas. It's good to have this young man back in the lineup. Patrick Mathis, pinch hit, as Greg told you, late in the game on Sunday. Now getting an opportunity, not playing defense yet, but healthy enough to be the DH.
We saw during batting practice and before batting practice, him talking with Augie and Mike West, the trainer. He waited till after batting practice. Michael Cantu was in the lineup originally.
Ripped by into left field. Texas has got a chance to get on the board. As Barrera comes in to score. Nice welcome back to Patrick Mathis. RBI single, 1-0 Texas.
That's why you like him back in the lineup. Right there, this fastball is well off the plate. Outside to Mathis. He just puts the bat on it, shoots it by the shortstop.
Texas able to play with a lead now. Cody Clements steps in. Mathis at first. Not a threat right now to run. And recruit. This ball hit pretty well out toward left, carrying well. Going back is Smith. Nice running catch right up against the wall to take extra bases away from Cody Clements.
Wow. According to the flags in center field, there's no breeze. Cody barreled this one up. This ball carries all the way onto the warning track. Good play out there in left by Smith.
Two gone now. Brady Harlan steps in. Squares to bunt, pulls the bat back. Harlan, the freshman from Corsicana. He's taking advantage of his opportunity. See him, he's more patient at the plate. He's not going outside the zone as much. You can tell he's getting more comfortable as a hitter.
Yeah, because we've We've seen him come off the bench swinging every time. He's recognized that the pitcher's been a little off here in the first two innings.
Good pitch by Brown that time. Hits the inside corner. And it's 1-2 to Harlan. Tied him up. Cross the diamond in time. And the inning over. But not before Texas takes advantage of a leadoff walk. Comes up with a clutch base hit. And takes a 1-0 lead. Fans enjoying a 1-0 lead as we go to the home half of the third. Texas has had the leadoff batter, Greg, reach in both first two frames with leadoff walks. Mathis came up with the RBI base hit. Texas with a 1-0 lead. So 9-1-2 due here for Texas as we go to the home half of the third.
We had a good eye the first two innings, two walks. Seeing that Cody Brown struggles with command of that fastball the first two innings.
The junior from San Antonio steps in. Zane Gerwitz. Last three ball games, Zane's been in the ninth spot in the order. He led off all the other starts. He started every ball game for Texas in center. One hit well down the right field line. This is going to go for extra bases. Gerwitz on his way to second. Stand up, leadoff double.
Pretty good pop here by Zane. Fastball outer half coming back into the barrel. Zane hits it. Takes a second to catch up where it is. Ball gets right down in the right field corner, an easy double.
Do the little things here. Get him over, get him in. Failed to do that in the first after the walk and the pass ball. Third straight inning where Texas leadoff batter has reached base. Travis Jones steps in. He walked his first time up. Chops on the ground. Gerwitz makes his way to third. I thought for a second Frigé was going to go to third, and he probably should have there. I think he gets Gerwitz if Frigé goes to Beam right there.
Yeah, you're as a runner with the balls in front of you like that is to Zane. You're told to stay back at second base, but Frigé doesn't even look, doesn't even offer. Gets the sure out at first.
Infield drawn up by Sam Houston State as Boswell steps in. Boswell fly to left his first time up. All downstairs. Nice job by Cannon to keep that in front. Greg, I don't think I've seen a center fielder where Johnson is playing in center, Bryce Johnson. I have not seen one that shallow here unless it was the bottom of the 10th inning in extra innings, and that was the winning run at third. Very shallow in center is Johnson.
Tells me he's confidence in his speed, confidence in his ability to get good breaks on the ball.
Brown now down 3-0.
Green light.
I would. Did. Chopped on the ground. Didn't get it done, though, as Augie Garrido turns. Boswell loose there, 3-0, but a nice pitch by Brown to get an out. I think that's the proper play, an aggressive play right there.
That ball just got in on Brett. But on a green light, you don't have to swing. And really, you're keying one spot. The ball just got in on.
You're looking for a ball you can get airborne.
Right.
Joe Baker popped up his first time. Jones was running from second, was doubled up. It'll take a two-out hit now by Texas. Squares to bunt, bunts it foul. So 0-1 to Baker.
In all actuality, that's not going to drive the run in.
The third baseman was really coming down quickly. You're right.
The third baseman right there with him. I mean, the only play would probably be to pitch the ball to home. Or you get thrown out at first base and the run doesn't score anyway. I would think
Baker
he might
asking,
be told that right here.
This is one of those situations where Baker asked for the timeout. This is an offensive timeout. You get three of them in a game, but a player can ask for it as well as a coach. Coach Garrido did not ask for a offensive timeout, but Baker asked for it.
Joe possibly could have thought he saw a sign.
Ready to go now. Both teams with two hits apiece. Texas leads 1-0. Brown set again. Ripped into center for a base hit. Texas with a 2-0 lead. Third of the game in the books. Joe Baker gives Texas a 2-0 lead with a two outs single to right. When you look at Sam Houston State, they've had a tough schedule to start. You can see they've already played Tech, Oklahoma, Baylor, Rice, and by the way, they opened the year with three at University of Louisiana at Lafayette, which is a top 12 program right now. So they have played a very difficult schedule to start the year. And the one that jumps off the page, they swept Oklahoma
at home.
Three-game set.
Yeah, they did. Well, you find out a lot about your team. A lot of it non-conference schedule. I mean, when you play a tough schedule, it only prepares you for the tough conference schedule.
Well, and the Southland Conference has always been a very good baseball conference. Greg, you've worked in it and coached in it and watched it, and I've coached in it and watched it, and it never gets the amount of bids that should come out of that conference, because each year only the champion seems to come out of it into the postseason. A lot of good teams there. Cooper quickly out in the head now, 0-2. The 1-2 to McKnight, got him. Fourth strikeout of the game for Morgan Cooper.
Tried the fastball away. Didn't get the call. Tress wants the fastball in. Morgan threw it right to the mitt. Got the swing.
Zach Smith will step in. Smith singled his first time up. Some unusual leg kicks. Guys that hit, they do not get cheated. For the Bearcats. Watch this leg kick.
He gets back there and gets balanced on that back leg. He keeps it back there.
Got to time it to get it down. See, that time the fastball buying, Greg, and he gets back right here, and does the fat front foot gets down? Not quite in time to him have to get his hands forward.
It would be tough, I would think, to get some good timing.
One and two to Smith. Hit well out toward left. Jones trying to get to it. Yes, he does. Nice running catch, Travis Jones.
A real good catch. Ball's slicing away from him. From our angle, it looked like for a second it was going to get over his head, but 6'4". with the speed of Travis Jones, he caught up with it pretty easy.
Hunter Hearn steps in. Hearn struck out his first time up. Freshman from Crosby. Pitch right there. You make a living knee high on the outer, that outside corner. And it's 1-2.
Since falling behind the first three hitters of the game, Morgan's done a real good job of getting ahead, getting that first pitch strike.
8 out of the last 9 hitters, he's done that too. The 1-2. Got him. 3 in a row, retired by Cooper. 5th strikeout of the game.
We met.
Dakota Mills comes into the game. Mills, 6'2", 220-pound junior transfer from Meadows Place and Blinn Junior College as he comes on into the game here. Second pitcher of the ball game for the Sam Houston State Bearcats. Barrera walked and scored his first time up. Cody Brown started the game for Sam Houston State. Gave up the 3 hits and the 2 runs. Pitchers have struggled with strikes for the Bearcats so far, Greg.
Yeah, leadoff hitter of the game. A walk. The second inning, a walk. And now Tres Barrera starts the 4th inning with a walk.
Well, you look at it, folks. Texas needed to get their leadoff hitter on base. They've done that in every frame, all 4 frames in the ball game, and they've gotten some base hits with runners in scoring position.
Yeah, they got a leadoff double to start an inning. He eventually scored. They're not just getting the extra base hits tonight. They have the walks. They have 3 walks now. So Texas getting on base, and Joe Baker with a big 2-out single to score the 2nd run of the game for Texas.
When you look at the ball game started, as Mark Cooper got out of the first, as we were talking about, then in the 2nd, Mathis, who a late replacement, came on as the DH. He's been injured with a pulled hamstring, comes up with a big base hit there. Then in the 3rd, with 2 outs, Joe Baker, opposite field base hit, driving the 2nd run of the ball game. Texas with a 2-0 lead. They've taken advantage of that opportunity, that leadoff base runner. Augie Garrido used an offensive timeout right there to the 2nd of the game he's used to talk to Casey Clemens after the Barrera walk. But Jones walked in the 1st, was doubled up on a fly ball. Barrera walked in the 2nd to lead it off, scored. The leadoff double by Gerwitz in the 3rd led to a run, and now a leadoff walk here in the 4th. Mills has not thrown a strike since coming into the game.
Well, I'm not going to do him a favor and bunt a ball on the ground if he can't throw strikes. I'm going to keep going until I get a strike.
Bunted hard to 1st, popped up. Biles has it for the 1st out of the inning.
Casey trying to pull that ball with him. Looked like the pitch was up in the zone. Very tough pitch to bunt on the ground, the ball up.
It's good to have him back. Patrick Mathis back in the lineup tonight as the DH. Still not playing in the field at this point, but he's been the number 3 hitter. He was penciled in there to start the season as maybe one of the best offensive players for Texas. He hit 2 home runs in that 1st series of the year. His last 2 times up, a single to center. In a pinch hitting role, and then this ball hit well out into center, stays in the park. Johnson has it, puts it away for the 2nd out of the inning, but it's good to have Mathis back in this lineup.
Well, he's a power threat, and that's something Texas needs. They've gotten a couple from Casey Clemens, 1 from Brett Boswell. But he proved that 1st weekend of the season that he has power. Hit one over the 405 sign in center right, and then also went opposite field against UNLV.
Cody Clemens steps in. He drove Smith, the left fielder, against the wall his first time up. But 0 for 1 in this one as he steps in. Ball gets away from Cannon. Second time in the game we've seen a ball. It's almost like he's anticipating a different type of pitch.
Yeah, that one just handcuffed him right there.
Yeah.
As if he's going down to block it. You see right here. Getting ready to block it, and the ball just stays up. Very fortunate that it didn't go far from it.
I think that's the second pass ball of the day, and it is.
Almost like that's the one he was expecting. That one was in the dirt.
Two and 0 to Clemens. Misses upstairs.
Coach Diggs told us before the game that we will see a lot of pitching today. Dakota Mills the second. They do have action in the bullpen. It's always difficult sometimes when you play those weekend series, come back on a Tuesday. Miles Manning.
He talked about, felt like he had some arms. He said, we just haven't thrown a lot of strikes. We've seen that so far. Popped up out of play. That's a full count. You can't defend the base on balls.
So my dad told me that at an early age. Get the ball over the plate, let the defense work for you. Kind of just takes the energy out.
I've always heard the word, you're selfish if you don't let your other guys play. Break the ball, foul back. Being a selfish player, the pitcher, don't throw strikes. Three-two curveball, foul back. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming. Out toward left, gave it a ride again. This ball's really carrying. It's got a chance. It's out of here. Opposite field, two-run shot. Cody Clemens, 4-0 Texas.
Look at the smiles on those Texas players. His brother gives him a little pick-me-up there. He almost got him his first at-bat to left field. Almost got Cody Brown. This ball right here by Cody. Out over the plate. He just centers it.
Good extension. Top of the baseball gets great rotation. And that's out of here easily.
Yeah, that's in the Bearcat bullpen pretty good. Very fortunate that it didn't go far from it.
I think that's the second pass ball of the day, and it is.
It's almost like that's the one he was expecting. That one was in the dirt.
Two and 0 to Clemens. Misses upstairs.
Coach Diggs told us before the game that we will see a lot of pitching today. Dakota Mills the second. They do have action in the bullpen. It's always difficult sometimes when you play those weekend series, come back on a Tuesday. Miles Manning.
Talked about, felt like he had some arms. He said, we just haven't thrown a lot of strikes. We've seen that so far. Popped up out of play. That's a full count. You can't defend the base on balls.
So my dad told me that at an early age. Get the ball over the plate, let the defense work for you. It kind of just takes the energy out.
I've always heard the word, you're selfish if you don't let your other guys play. Break a ball, foul back. Being a selfish player, a pitcher, don't throw strikes. Three-two curveball, foul back. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming. Out toward left, gave it a ride again. This ball's really carrying. It's got a chance. It's out of here. Opposite field, two-run shot. Cody Clemens, 4-0 Texas.
Look at the smiles on those Texas players. His brother gives him a little pick-me-up there. He almost got him his first at-bat to left field. Almost got Cody Brown. This ball right here by Cody. Out over the plate, he just centers it.
Good extension. Top of the baseball, gets great rotation. And that's out of here easily.
Yeah, that's in the Bearcat bullpen pretty good.
Reddy Harlan steps in. He grounded to third his first time up. Texas has taken advantage of the leadoff base runner. Mills has fell behind all five batters he's faced since coming into the game. This is again downstairs. Four runs on four hits for Texas. Two-oh ripped on the ground. Nice job by Biles, underhands to Mills. And that ends the inning, but not before Texas does damage again. First career home run by Cody Clemens. Augie Garrido up next.
Today we're going to...
We go to the top of the fifth. Texas has scored in three of their four at-bats, and we go down into the Texas dugout and visit with their head coach, Augie Garrido. Coach, this game is really one that can beat you up. You mentioned it a lot on Sunday after the game. You come back, but the great thing about baseball, you get to come back the next day and play or the day after.
Well, that's right, and it's how much you learn from the beating and how you respond to it.
Coach, Morgan Cooper, been through a lot. This is his second start of the season. It's good to see the progression he's making.
The progression he's making and the fearless way that he's pitching is really rewarding, and the whole team is rallying around that. You add Connor Mays's that was a great home run against Arizona State.
Anyway,
Connor Mays throwing the way he threw on Sunday, and now you add Morgan to that that pitching staff, and you've got something pretty special.
Thanks for taking the time,
You're
Coach.
Welcome. Thank you.
Visit with head coach Augie Garrido. His line that you read Monday morning around Coach Garrido, it is a cruel game, the game of baseball. There's nothing that makes it easy, I can tell you. This ball hit pretty well to center by Cannon. Going back is Gerwitz, just short of the track. Puts it away for the first out of the inning.
You're talking about that Connor Rowe homer. I think that's a world record for getting around the bases after hitting a home run.
Boy, he did sprint around the base pass. So one gone for Barrett Corsum, who comes in for Selman, is a freshman from Huntsville. Big, strong right-handed hitter. Does not get cheated.
It's good to see Morgan just pumping in strikes right now.
Well, I think the bottom right of your corner where you see 53 pitches. That's the part that's impressed me. He's been very efficient as well.
Only 16 balls out of the zone out of a total of 54.
A little better than a 2-to-1 ratio. Popped out toward left. Everybody runs out of room. It'll be 1-2 again. Little things tonight. You're just tuning in. Congratulations to
these
you.
These two right here. This one here, he had a shot at it on the bounce. It got by him. Now little sister's saying, no.
She's got it.
I got it.
Rides in on it and gets a piece of it.
You know, here's the foul ball. This one right here had already missed it. And then little sister jumps in. Come on. They're going to get it from her. Nope. She got two hands on
it. She ain't giving that up. Biles steps in, just pulls it foul. Josh Biles grounded to short his first time up. The 0-1 downstairs. 29 new players for Sam Houston State this season, for a program that has had 16 players drafted, Greg, since 2011.
It's pretty solid. Five each of the last 2 years.
Breaking ball swings over the top of it, so a lot of young players. Matt Diggs in his second year. See that, 19 freshmen. 29 new players with junior college transfers to go along with the 19 freshmen. Got him with a fastball. Sixth strikeout of the game for Morgan Cooper.
And third looking. See, Tress wants that fastball on the inner half and down. Morgan Cooper with a good angle.
Taylor Bean will step in. He flied to left his first time up.
You got to work and get a strikeout looking inside, come back to the next hitter and get that fastball outside. He's got command of the fastball tonight.
I like the fact that he really doesn't change expression. He doesn't try to umpire. He's got great mound presence. He had as a freshman in 2014, he had great mound presence. He looks in, gets the sign, gets ready to go to work, throws the ball, lets the umpire do his job, gets the ball, and gets ready to go again. I would think he's obviously in position right now, an out away from qualifying for the victory, but I would think he might be able to come out in the sixth. 2-1, another good pitch. Count evens at 2-2.
Get out of this inning under 70 pitches. Give him the opportunity to come out and pitch the sixth inning.
2-2. Just misses in there.
He has confidence in himself, and that's why you see more mound presence out of him than other pitchers. He knows that he can come back and repeat the pitch again.
Runner will be off here, 3-2. Breaking ball, just gets a piece of it. Keep the bat alive. How about that? The courage and the ability to throw a 3-2 breaking ball right there. And being able to foul it off.
bat right here by Bean.
Able to foul the curve off before that, and then that pitch right there was more impressive. The fastball that's almost by you, able to get the bat on it just a little bit.
Fouled off again. Good at bat going on right here. He's 93 on that fastball that time. Tenth pitch of the at bat coming now. Junior from Humble steps back in. Got him with a changeup.
See Trace's reaction? Trace wanted that pitch. He had the confidence that Morgan Cooper could get that over in a 3-2 count. What's the reaction by Trace Barrera on the changeup? Morgan Cooper out of the inning. The horns are up 4-0.
Welcome back to UFCU Dish Falk Field, 4-0 Texas. We go to the bottom of the fifth, and we take this opportunity to go down into the Bearcats dugout and visit with their second-year head coach, Matt Diggs. Coach, you told us before the game that you'd have some young guys that would come really take some hacks, and they haven't been afraid, I will say, when they've stepped in the box, they've gotten their hacks in.
No, they're going to compete. They're going to dig in, looking to get their swings off, and we've done that. We've hit some balls hard. They've got a really good arm on the mound. He's throwing downhill. I don't know what his velo is, but he's got a good breaking ball to go with it. And he just finished off a 10-pitch at bat there with a changeup. So go figure. But he's a good arm. We've walked a couple, two or three guys that have scored, and there hasn't been a whole lot of offense so far on either side.
Well, one of the last things I want to talk about, as the night goes on and you get into conference, one of the things you're trying to build is letting these guys get some experience when you get into conference play.
Well, they've been swimming in the deep end all year. I mean, we didn't just, you know, push them in. We picked them up and threw them in the deep end. We've had an incredible schedule, and I like the way they compete. They play hard. They show up to punch a time card every day. We're going to do nothing but get better.
Thanks so much for visiting with, and good luck to you and your team.
Thanks, guys.
It's Coach Diggs in his second season. And the new pitcher is Miles Manning. He is a senior as he comes on for Manning. He is a 5'9", 180-pound senior from Victoria, making his eighth appearance on the year. Zane Gerwitz doubled, scored his last time up. Texas has had the leadoff hitter, Greg, reach base in all four frames.
It's paying off. Four innings, four leadoff hitters on, 4-0. It's what they've done after that. They've been able to
produce.
First inning, they didn't get the run in, but since then, they've been able to get hits after the extra base hits, move the runners over.
Gerwitz going the other way again, his second hit of the night. Fifth of the ball game for Texas. So far, so good for the Texas offense. Five innings, five leadoff batters have reached base. Back to the top of the order in Travis Jones.
Good inside out by Zane. Right there, fastball tailing in. Stayed inside it.
Travis steps in. He walked his first time up and is grounded to short. Squares the bunt. Pulls it back. The arms for Sam Houston Strait have struggled with command. That's the difference in the game. That and the two-run homer by Cody Clemens.
Try to get the guys moving, show bunt, pull it back. When you do that, you got to hit that ball on the ground. You got the defense moving, Greg, but that's when you got to make contact. Nothing in the air at that point, because that doesn't do you any good. Even though the infield's moving, it doesn't do you any good. But on the ground, if that infield's moving, you can sneak one through pretty easily.
With the speed of Travis, you don't even have to sneak it through. You just sneak it where they were, out of position. We've seen Texas try that a few times this year.
Gets the call. And the count full. Scoreboard, I think it's 2-2. Scoreboard has it a full count. I think it's a 2-2 count. Scoreboard adjusted. And it is 2-2.
Now the sign above the count says full count.
Runner going. Hit on the ground. Tough play in the hole. Jones with outstanding speed beats it out. Throw gets away, on his way to third is Gerwitz, on his way to second is Jones.
With the speed of Travis right here, this is a tough play for Fajay at shortstop. Has to rush his throw. Travis would have beat that. Throw wide, gets under Josh Biles down at first base. Both runners advance 90 feet.
Gerwitz really did a nice job. He was going to third one way or the other, did a nice job of rounding the bag and was headed to third regardless if the throw was on time. First miscue of the game by either club, base hit. E6, the advance to second for Jones.
Take a look at Zane. Right here, as he's going to second base. Looks in to see where the ball is. Checks the throw.
As soon as
advances
he
to third base.
As soon as he saw it offline, he was ready to go looking for it. Good anticipation. Manning misses outside. Chance to blow the thing open if you're Texas right now. Bet 0 for 2 in this one.
Ooh.
Didn't like that call.
That's a tough pitch to hit. So might as well take it. That ball's inside. It tailed back in over the inner half of the plate.
1-2 to Boswell. Good changeup. Had him over the top of it. First strikeout for Manning. One gone in the inning.
Location, location, location.
That was a good pitch. First strikeout, not only for Manning, but for the Bearcats tonight. Came at a big time right there. Infield comes up now. For Sam Houston State as Joe Baker steps in. Baker 1-for-2 and an RBI single. Manning hits the outside corner for strike one. Look for something up here if you're a hitter right now. You want something you can elevate into center field. Not sure what that pitch was.
A little breaking ball.
That backed up.
I don't think it was the change. I mean, it just stayed up.
The 1-1. Breaking ball lined to center for a base hit. Jones is held at third. Baker has his second RBI single of the night. Five to nothing, Texas.
Joe continues to produce. That's a good pitch. That's a slider low and away. See, Joe keeps his head on it. That's what this pitch is. That ball's off the plate.
Barrera will step in. Trace has scored twice, walked twice. RBI situation here.
Still looking for that first home run. You know, now you see that Cody Clemens has one down at third base. You know there's going to be a little competition going there.
The 1-0. Off the plate in. Bearcats looking for double play ball in the infield. Texas has scored in 4 of 5 frames. One in the second, one in the third, 2 in the fourth, and now one here in the fifth. Runner goes. Throw down to second, stolen base. So Baker 1 for 2 tonight in the stolen base department.
Now 5 for 6 on the season.
3-0. I think he probably had the green light, but that's,
see the
that's not a pitch
face.
To hit.
No, you want that pitch that's your pitch. You're still going to have more opportunity if you don't swing.
3-1, misses outside, and that loads the bases. Casey Clemens will stride to the plate. He has sacrificed and popped up. Sam Houston looking for a double play ball. Texas looking to break it wide open right here. Casey's been on a tear since putting on the spectacles. The 1-0.
I'd be careful with that one. Casey got a good look at that pitch.
He's a good high fastball hitter. The 1-1. Ball crushed into the gap into right center. All the way to the wall. This should clear the bases. Barrera rounding third. He will score. 3-run double. Casey Clemens. 8-0 Texas.
Gets the fastball out over the plate this time. Drives this ball to the gap in right center. Chris recognizes, gets a good jump. Comes all the way around to score. We're going to see a new pitcher.
Texas has taken advantage, scored in every frame. And the Bearcats go to the bullpen. We'll give you the new chunker when we come back. 8-0 Texas. Texas here in the bottom of the fifth inning. 8 runs on 8 hits. Texas has scored in every frame but the first. The Bearcats go to the bullpen again to get Dane Lovejoy. He's a junior from Lorena, 6'1", 180 pounder, making his 6th appearance on the year for the Bearcats. Patrick Mathis will stride to the plate. Mathis has fly deep to center and singled to drive in a run. First start, even though in a DH role, that Mathis has had since the first series of the year. It's good to get the sophomore back from Waco, back into the Texas lineup. Lovejoy misses up and away, ball one.
Lovejoy, fastball slider pitcher. Get a few lefties here in a row. Come in and try to get them out as they get a right-hander up in the bullpen.
Four hits and a walk in the frame, and four on the board. These two guys might have faced each other. Lorena and Waco, not far apart. Popped up. Difficult play, called off. Johnson, the center fielder, makes the play. Second out of the inning. That brings Cody Clemens to the plate. First career home run, his last time up.
It's funny hearing Cody before the game. Oh. You have a weekend like Texas just had, and you're struggling a little bit at the plate. He said he was getting calls and texts and everything from friends going, what's wrong? What's going on? He was like, just leave me alone.
That's exactly right.
Well, I think he answered him in that last inning when he got the home run.
Always trying to work on little things as a hitter all the time. And I'm sure you did as a pitcher all the time, trying to tweak things all the time. Breaking ball in the dirt, moving up to third, his older brother Casey. This happened earlier in the game, just to the end two-run shot in the fourth. And out of here easily the other way. The 2-0. Tied him up, and it's 2-1. You want to keep grinding through these at-bats, Greg. You've heard me say that before. In a game that's one side or another, as a player, you just don't give them away. Keep working on your game. Nips the corner, and the count evens.
Yeah, it can be very easy to go up there and not worry too much. Just take a half-hearted at-bat. Doesn't do any good.
Still got to commit. The 2-2. This is outside, and the count full. Lovejoy set. Fought it off and do it again. Longhorns will travel this weekend out to UCLA in Los Angeles. On the ground, back up the middle, base hit. 9-0 Texas. Cody Clemens with his third RBI of the night. Does a nice job staying in there, 3-2, fighting off a couple of good pitches. As Casey comes in to score. Big brother says, nice going, little brother. 9 runs on 9 hits now for Texas. Brady Harlan steps in. Harlan looking for his first hit of the night. A The Longhorns' ninth batter of the inning. 5 hits in the inning. 1 extra base hit in the inning. The double by Casey Clemens that drove in 3. Difference in tonight's game. Obviously, Texas has 9 runs on 9 hits, but the inability to throw strikes from Sam Houston State, the big part of the game.
Yeah, they've put Texas in a lot of good hitting counts. Texas has shown a good eye as well, getting walks. But when they have got the strikes, they put them in play for hits.
Back to the Longhorns over the next 4 ball games. Got him upstairs. 9 to the plate in the inning. Damage done, though, as Texas puts a 5 spot on the board.
Morgan Cooper tonight has been given a 9-run lead, but he has been on top of his game early on. Getting strikeouts, getting the feel for the curveball, locating the fastball. A good angle downhill. And getting the changeup. And exciting as catcher Chris Barrera behind the plate. See the numbers on the night. 5 innings, 2 hits, both in the first inning. And a career-high 7 strikeouts.
Out for his 6th inning of work. Ball popped up. Barrera underneath, drops it. Barrera right there would like to go back and take his mask off, I would think. Just haven't seen him do that very often. He says, hey, that's my fault. Should have got an out right here.
Just kind of half-hearted right at the end here.
I think if you get rid of your mask, young catchers, if you get rid of that mask, if that ball moves a little bit, yes, you can probably see pretty well in the mask, but you can see better without it, I guarantee you.
And get underneath it.
Frigier steps back in. .912 due here for the Bearcats. Got 2 base hits in the first inning against Cooper since then. Cooper has had 1 base runner since the first, and that's when he hit a batter in the 5th. I think he would be around 80 pitches at the end of his window.
Texas has action in the bullpen.
Ball ripped out to left, and that happens so many times. Should have been out. Turns into a base hit. So back to the top of the order, and Bryce Johnson.
And that play called an error sometimes. It was an easy play.
I think you can give an error on the play without affecting
anything.
There's doesn't give a base runner, but it still could be a miscue. Johnson steps in. Singled his first time up, was stranded at third, and is grounded to short. It actually does, they do give E2 on the play. Skip Johnson out to talk to his big right-hander.
Well, what it did was make Morgan throw an extra 5 or 6 pitches, getting him closer to that pitch count. I think this one right here is just a talk to get his mind back on the strike zone and not worry about what just happened.
Texas baseball returns to UFCU Dish Falk Field to host a 3-game series versus Tulane. Game 1 starts Friday, March 18th. First pitch at 6 o'clock Central Time. Then stick with us all weekend, Saturday and Sunday, for the remaining games. To catch all the action live on Longhorn Network, streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Tulane, the top 30 in a lot of polls. The Green Wave with a good baseball team, no doubt about it. Ground ball, this could be two. Really good turn between Baker and Boswell because Johnson can really scoot and get down the line. Excellent turn.
Bryce Johnson has the speed. It all starts right there with the feed to Brett Boswell and a quick release by Brett. Good feed, good release.
Riley McKnight will step in. Knight, he's done a sacrifice. Swings through that one and then struck out in his two plate appearances. Yeah, taking the Barrera miscue off the board, I guess because it didn't affect the outcome. They made a decision to not charge Barrera with an error. The 0-2, got him. Finishing up strong. I would think that's the end of the night for Morgan Cooper. 6 shutout innings.
Coming to Texas and being able to wear this jersey, it's a dream come true of mine.
It means everything to me. Growing up, my room was actually burnt orange growing up. Comforter was burnt orange. My pillows are burnt orange.
You just look at all the greats that have come through here, that have walked through the locker room, have been on the same field, and it's really... It sends chills down your back.
Being a Texas baseball player, I mean, I get the chills when I just think about it. It's tradition.
When I wake up and when I go to bed, it's all I think about. Love these guys to death. They're like my brothers, and it's just an honor to be able to wear the burnt orange.
Texas is the cream of the crop in all of Division I, and I'm just proud to wear the name across the front of my chest.
Right now, that name has a 9-0 lead as we go to the bottom of the 6th. 9 runs on 9 hits. We've seen a miscue, put on the board, off the board. We're not sure what happened.
It's off now. It's off again.
It's Colin Cameron, the 6'3", 190-pound freshman from the Woodlands, comes into the game. He'll be facing Zane Gerwitz, his 3rd time to lead off an inning in the 9th spot in the order. 5th appearance for Cameron.
You brought me to the 9-hole, but I'm leading off every inning.
Well, he's doubled and singled, scored twice.
Good breaking ball.
Good production up and down this lineup tonight. Sam Houston State has not retired the first Longhorn hitter in any frame in the ballgame. Texas leads 9-0. Week from tonight, the Longhorns travel 90 miles to the east and take on Texas A&M on a Tuesday night game. So the next 4 ball games will be on the road for Texas. 3 in Los Angeles to play UCLA. And next Tuesday at Texas A&M. Before coming back home, we'll have all 3 games of the Tulane series right here on LHN. Right side on the ground. Easy put out for the first out of the inning and the first time that a Bearcat has retired a Longhorn to lead off an inning.
It'll be pretty exciting at College Station a week from tonight.
I would think that would be a packed house.
A lot of orange.
A lot of orange in the building, a lot of maroon. Texas A&M off to a fantastic start in the top five in most polls in the country.
And a solid looking program again this year.
See the history. The last 3 meetings were in the NCAA tournament where Texas won 2 out of 3 and went on to the Super Regional. The first regular season matchup since Texas A&M move to the Southeast Conference.
I believe Texas won that game on a Jonathan Walsh scored late in the game.
Hit on the ground is short. Across the diamond in time, two quick outs. Attack this. Gotta attack it. Jones has got good speed. Did a nice job of rounding it, squaring his shoulders. Making a good throw across the diamond. Brett Boswell will step in. Looking for his first hit of the night. Cameron's done a nice job of mixing in three pitches, fastball, change, and a breaking ball. We call it a pure slider. It's more of a slurve.
I got a little loop in it.
Caught him. Just nipped his inside of his elbow. So the Longhorns will not go 1-2-3, which they have in any inning in the ball game. And Joe Baker comes to the plate. Joe's had a good night. He's 2-for-3 as he steps in. He's driven in a couple and scored one. Cameron misses upstairs for ball one. Baker out in front now, two balls and no strikes. Popped up. Foul territory. Going to be a difficult play. Ooh.
Good effort. Kind of took the padding of that wall right up in the top of his chest, did Frigé. Even though it's padding, there's 10 inches of cement behind that pad.
Usually it's your toe or your knee, and boy, I think it's his right knee that hit that padding really hard. Tough young man, true freshman. Good effort. Just a little bit over 2 weeks, Greg. Actually, 2 weeks and 2 days. We start conference play here at UFCU as the TCU Horned Frogs come in for a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series for those folks on Easter weekend. They're off to announce. Well, partner, you're going to catch that one. That was a little bit low to reach your hand out, try to get.
Yeah. My arms aren't that long. You grab my legs if I fall out?
Well, I'll try to grab. Oh, I don't know if I can hold you.
Well, as long as you're giving me an effort.
I'm going to give you an effort.
Okay.
I'm not going to promise you anything.
Thing.
The payoff pitch. Ripped through the middle. Third hit of the night for Baker. Boswell rounds second on his way to third. Longhorns with a threat here with two outs. Third hit of the night for Joe Baker.
Well, Joe has hit the ball hard, except for that first time up. Got jammed and popped up to third. Next three at-bats, line drives.
Tenth hit of the ball game for Texas. Third straight single. His last three plate appearances for Baker. Guerrero has walked three times and scored three times. Reaching. Out of play and down now 0-2. So reach for that breaking ball. Cameron set. Pass ball chopped on the ground. Long throw across the diamond in time. And that ends the inning. Texas doesn't score here in the sixth. We're through two-thirds of the game. 9-0 Texas.
She became the first.
Next, come on. Who wants to get wet? Get on in there. Climb on in there. I am on today. Yes! Next. Don't be shy. Get in there. Burning daylight. Let's go. Yes!
Hey, I thought the fans were supposed to dunk Roger.
Yeah, there was some confusion about that.
Nobody wanted to tell him.
Everybody's getting wet today. Everybody.
Absolutely not.
Who's next? Come on. Let's go. Yes!
We're back. The Horns leading the Bearcats 9-0. See, Morgan Cooper started this game. You see his numbers on the season. A relief, 2 innings, 34 pitches. His first start against Texas State, 4 innings, 62 pitches. And tonight, he was on an 80-pitch count, went 6 innings, and threw 80 pitches. Gave up the 3 hits and a career-high 8 strikeouts. New pitcher for the Longhorns now will be Bo Ridgway, freshman out of the Woodlands, Texas. Came in after Morgan Cooper last week at Texas State. Pitched well over the weekend in relief. You see the numbers, 7 hits, just the 1 walk and 3 strikeouts, this being his 6th appearance.
Ridgway will face the 3, 4, and 5 spots as Zach Smith steps in. Smith 1-for-2 in this one. Singled in the first.
That was a good sinker slider pitcher. His last 2 outings, his velocity's been better. His location has been better. This 91 with some sink from the side.
You can tell he's gotten more confidence with each appearance that he's made. Ridgway working quickly, 1-2, fouled off. Keep the at bat alive by Smith. Hit pretty well out into left center on his horses. Gerwitz, nice running catch, Zane Gerwitz, to take extra bases away from Zach Smith.
This ball's crushed on the line. Zane with a good route, went over and then back, kept his eye on it the whole time. And stayed on his feet.
Grissom will be the pinch hitter. We have a pinch hitter, Jackson Grissom. Grissom will step in. College Station, 6'275", true freshman. Ridgway into the windup. Single to center, 4th hit of the night. If you're a pinch hitter, see that first fastball? Put a good hack on it. Pitch hitting's the toughest thing in the world to do. If you haven't swung the bat in a couple hours, so you walk up there and look for the first fastball and try to put the best swing you can on it.
He hasn't seen. He just saw 5 pitches from Ridgway. That's all he's seen from him. He goes up there and puts a good swing.
Jordan Cannon will step in, 0-for-2. At what point, Greg, do you think some of these young hitters, we'll get to it after this 0-1 pitch, breaking ball, did he go? Yes, he did. It's quickly 0-2. You get into the third of the season, the fourth of the season, at what point do young players start to say, well, they're no longer young anymore?
If they're playing every day.
That's what he's trying to do. You can tell with Coach Diggs. He said, I'm putting guys out there that They're physical. They got some talent. They're just going to have those days where they play really well, and that's what you're going to get with a young team.
And the schedule you play. I mean, these guys, young kids, have grown up already with the schedule they've played.
Baylor, Rice, Oklahoma.
Ooh la la.
Texas Tech. And now Texas.
It is right up on the plate.
Count goes full.
Seems with the sink that Bo has, that one right up on his hands right here.
Tied him up. Runner was off. Trying to stay out of the double play. Tough to get to.
Good, well, we're fighting it off. Easier at 3-2, I guess. Looking fastball.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming. Throw over, it gets away. This one down to second. I believe that will be E1. As a first baseman, you try everything you can do to get this ball knocked down, Greg, but sometimes it's just you can't reach it.
You see the throw from Ridgeway, kind of up the line, the runner's coming back in, sliding in. Might not be expecting it either, up with a 9-0 lead.
Hit him. Rode up, caught him on the arm. Only the second time in the ball game the Bearcats have had two guys on in an inning. Of course, someone will step in. Barrett hit by a pitch. 0-for-1 in the ball game. Good Texas time. Looking for a double play ball, yeah? That's what they're looking for. With Bo's delivery, Greg, as we see it from the side, sort of a short arm. It comes out of an unusual spot a little bit for a hitter. Sometimes it might be tough to pick up. The 0-2. Just misses there.
Yeah, he's got that little herky-jerky movement right before he goes to the plate, and then the quick arm movement. The guys that have quick arm movements are always tougher to pick up.
Foul back, keeps the at bat alive. Arm slots, you know, some are over the top, some are out to the side, some are like three quarters. He's got to make sure from that arm slot that he uses when he gets on his breaking ball that he gets on top of it. See it right there, left it upstairs. Base hit to center, and that loads the bases. Just got, you know, that was the pitch I was just talking about. When you're in a certain spot, you got to stay on top of it to get a downward plane of the breaking ball.
And from that angle, the angle which he throws the sidearm, sometimes you can get around the side of it to make it be more of a slider instead of a curveball. That one there looked like he was in between.
The number 25
Horns return to McCombs Field to take on North Texas Wednesday. First pitch, 6 Central on LHN. Catch it all live on Longhorn Network, streaming on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Longhorns came from behind. Well, it didn't come from behind, but tie game won in extra innings tonight. Won the game 3-2 against the Roadrunners of UTSA earlier tonight. Josh Biles will step in, 0-for-2 in this one. Longhorns looking for a double play ball to preserve the shutout. Downstairs, ball one. Popped up, out of play down the left field line. You know, much like we saw on Sunday, it's one of those things you try to forget. Texas had a 7-0 lead. Dropped it in extra innings. This Bearcat club was down 9-1 on Friday night. Came back and won a ball game, so they don't ever feel like they're out of a game, and they got them loaded here in the seventh. Ripped down the left field line. That's going to go for extra bases. This could clear the bases. Ball gets away from Jones. They'll hold the runner at third. It's a 9-2 ball game. Breaking ball upstairs again.
That one hung out over the plate from Ridgeway. Just doesn't have the same bite on that breaking ball. Just rolled in there on the inner half. Two-run score, two are on.
Taylor Bean comes to the plate. Runners at second and third. Ball hit pretty well out to right. Harlan has a beat on it, tagging. Enough to get the job done, and it's a 9-3 ball game. Sacrifice fly. This started with a base hit to center and a hit batsman. Boucher steps in. He singled his last time up. 6 hits now in the ball game for the Bearcats.
Bo needs to make some pitches right here, because if anything, it can be lingering in the back of your mind what happened. For both these teams, like you said, the Bearcats came back.
Well, all of a sudden, you know, hey, we've done this before, and then they get a big hit, and on the other side, Texas just saw it on Sunday when they had a 7-0 lead. O-2, got the call on the outside corner. That ends the inning. But the Bearcats back in the ballgame. They put a 3 spot on the board. 9-3 ballgame. RBIs, Clemens style. As Casey and Cody have had a big night. Both have driven in 3. 6 of the 9 runs. So each scored a run as well. Cody with his first career home run as Austin Hoyt comes into the game. Seen a few pitchers tonight. Redshirt freshman from Kingwood. Casey Clemens will lead it off. 4th appearance of the year for Austin. The number that jumped off the page when I saw that, 7 strikeouts and 5 1/3.
And 5 1/3 and 10 hits. It was hit or miss.
This is outside. 3 runs, 6 hits, 1 miscue For Sam Houston State, 9 runs, 10 hits, 2 errors for Texas. Ball jumps up on you. Velocity doesn't jump off the page, but you can tell that ball gets up on you in a hurry.
Drops that arm to the side and whips it.
Bearcats with a little momentum now. Texas would love to answer. Slowed his motion down on a changeup, missed downstairs, and it's 3-1. Texas has had the leadoff batter of the inning reach. In 5 of the first 6 frames.
He might have all these boys wearing glasses before it's over with. He's already got us wearing them.
3-2 on the ground. Going to be a difficult play. Nice job. Great hustle. One unassisted. Something you don't see very often right there. Good athletic move for the first out of the inning.
That's one you also work on when you're taking your PFP, your pitcher's fielding practice. If you can get to it, you take it, and since your momentum is already going that way, continue to the bag.
Biles trying to do everything he can do to get out of the way.
More times than not, that first baseman will be going for that ball as well. Communication.
Mathis steps in. His first start in a while, 1-for-3 in an RBI single. The 1-0. Left-hander should have an opportunity to see this ball pretty well. You see it the whole time, right there. But it just gets up on you. You can tell that arm motion and the slinging motion, hard to get on top of. Now to Mathis. Second 3-2 count. Just missed inside.
Didn't miss my bunch.
Texas will have a pinch runner as Tate Shaw will come out to run for Mathis. Back into the lineup, 1-for-3 for Patrick. Tate Shaw will be the pinch runner. Cody Clemens has had a big night. He's driven in 3. Opposite field, 2-run homer. RBI single his last time up. Outfield plays the other way for Cody. See Johnson in center really leaning over into left center. Clements down now quickly, 0-2.
He can actually see now that he has Oppo Pop. We saw it.
Deep into the bullpen.
On the ground, in the left, third hit of the night for Cody Clemens. Baker with three hits, Clemens with three hits, 11 total for Texas. Brady Harlan will step in. He's looking for his first hit of the night. Harlan with good speed, tough to double up.
Only horn not to reach base.
Oof. Not sure if that got foot or ankle. Might even been off of his knee.
Right below the knee.
Ooh. Pitch is thrown at 85 or 90. It comes off the bat faster most of the time than the ball being thrown in. So you know that was above, catching something above 90 miles an hour on the kneecap.
There's no protection that you can wear up there.
Nope. Right back in there. And with a good block. We've mentioned it all night. Sam Houston State with a very young club. A lot of guys getting their first experience at Division I baseball. This is a program, as we've talked about throughout the night, five guys drafted year before last, five last year, and 16 total since 2011. There have been some awful good players come through this program. Dating back to years ago, it's been a good program. John Skeeters was the head coach.
Mark Johnson.
You can see the seasons. Over the last four, so some pretty impressive numbers. Making regionals in 12 and in 14. That loads the bases. Every Longhorn has reached base safely in the game now as Zane Gerwitz comes to the plate. Doubled and scored, singled and scored, and grounded to second. Two for three tonight. Texas trying to answer the three spot here in the top of the seventh. Can see how difficult this would be on a right-handed hitter, the first one he's faced since coming into the game.
Yeah. A tough arm angle to pick up.
Ball hit well out toward left. Going back, Smith can't get to it. It's off the wall. Only one run will be able to score because the ball, Smith got it back in quickly. But it's a 10-3 ball game.
Zane is over there on first base, thinking, I just hit the wall with a line drive and I'm gonna get one RBI out of this. We got one RBI because Zach Smith down left field almost made an outstanding play. The runners had to hold up to see if the ball was gonna be caught. That man just saved a couple runs.
Travis Jones steps in. Travis 1-for-3. He scored a run tonight. Pitch in there for a strike. Jones with outstanding speed, tough to double up. Breaking ball in there, and quickly down on the count, 0-2.
That's one he did not try to the left-handers, is that little curve ball.
Inside corner started it out. Jones and brought it back to the inside corner. Got the strikeout.
Starts this curveball right at Travis's left hip. And it breaks right over the inner half.
So Boswell will step in. 0 for 3 tonight. Hit by a pitch his last time up. Now you can look for one pitch in one spot here. Struggling with command, and as a hitter, if I want the ball middle, I look middle. If I want it up, I'm looking up. Look for one pitch you can really put a good swing on.
With side armors tend to keep the ball down, so you are looking to get this ball up in the zone.
Popped it up. Out of play. At the college level, Greg, a lot of times you don't see hitters are able to really zone pitches out, but at this point in their careers, they should be able to zone locations out. I mean, if I'm a high ball hitter, I can zone out up or down. Nips the outside corner, and it's 2-2. And then the second thing, once you figure out, you know, low, down, or up, then the second thing you got to figure out is velocities. Am I going to look slow or hard? Two, two. Popped up. Back out of play as well. Three, six, and one for Sam Houston State. Now 10, 12, and two for Texas.
Just tried to get a change up in there to Brett. Had him out front.
Fastball hit pretty well to center. Going back is Johnson. Edge of the track, puts it away, and that ends the inning. But Texas on the board, 10-3 ball game.
Today,
there's some outstanding matchups across college baseball this weekend. Greg, when you look at it, the one I'm going to start at the bottom right. I think Georgia Tech undefeated at this time. That is a conference series in the ACC. Obviously traveling to Florida State. That's
undefeated.
Undefeated at this point of the year. And wow, one of the two teams undefeated. That was a big one, no question. And the USC and TCU, a good one to go with it. And then Texas Tech gets to take on the Cal Bears that just left, sweeping a four-game set here against Texas.
And TCU, second in the country in ERA, 1.23. The Tech's got their hands full up there. We just saw a very good Cal team that's won 8 of their last 9. Oregon found some starting pitching up there.
When you look at TCU, we'll be here right here in Austin. You can see their pitching staff just outstanding. Their phenom young freshman Lucan Baker, who is also swinging the bat quite well to go with that. He is a pitcher and the DH. Two-way player for the Horned Frogs. How about that top one? 28 shutouts.
And they lost a lot of pitching from last year. TCU did.
Yes, they did.
They're going to be right across town from where Texas is playing UCLA. New pitcher for Texas, Nolan Kingham. We've seen him start the last two Thursdays. Texas will not have any more Thursday games, so we can start to see Nolan coming out of the bullpen.
6'3 freshman from Las Vegas with a good sinking fastball. He'll face the top of the order here. Bryce Johnson, the sophomore from Cypress. One for three in the ball game.
And we're still trying to get his feet wet here at this level. He's called on to start his first start. The night before was supposed to be Josh Sawyer, and they told Nolan he was going to start. Started the last two Thursdays against Stanford and Cal.
Leadoff walk. Riley McKnight will step in. Mindset, Greg. You get a chance to start two times in a row, and now you're coming out of the pen. Does it change your mindset? How do you go about it? You know you're not going out there for 80 pitches. You know you've got a short-term appearance.
It changes the way when you start, you kind of want to conserve energy a little bit. You might come out in the first inning, you know, a little amped up, and then conserve it for your innings. But when you come out of the bullpen, you got to come out, normally come out with your best stuff. In the games, 10 to 3 games, maybe not your best. Usually runners are on base as a reliever, so you got to be on top of your game. There's really no change in the mindset.
Could be two. Baker steps on the back, throw to first in time. That'll change your mindset right there. Struggle with the first hitter, get a ground ball double play.
As a reliever, you really have to find it down in the pen. You're not going to have 4 or 5 innings to get under control and find your pitches.
Barrera comes right back out and says, all right, let's go now. Able to get through that. And you're right. I think one of the big statistics, it's not kept very often, but players know it, especially starting pitchers know it, is if you come in with runners on, how many of those you keep from scoring?
I've said it before. I started for 10 and relieved for 7. When I became a reliever, I really understood the importance of leaving those runners on base. That meant more to me as a relief pitcher than ERA, wins, losses, strikeouts. If I came in with 2 men on, I wanted to leave 2 guys out there when I left.
Popped up, out of play. Well, the guys that are really good at that, and the guys that pitch a long time too out of the bullpen, left or right-handed, but especially left-handed. Pretty well into the gap in left center. Gerwitz trying to get there. Can he get there? He'll run out of real estate. It'll fall in for extra bases.
Zach Smith.
Second hit of the night.
Zach Smith hit almost that same ball. His last at bat, a line drive to Zane out there in left center. This one here just goes to the warning track a little bit further.
Chisholm will step in, pinch hit. Stayed in the game in right field. Freshman from College Station. Singled his first time up. Back out, this should do it. Over to first and ends the inning. We head to the bottom of the 8th, 10-3 Texas. We go to the bottom of the 8th, 10-3 Texas. Texas tonight, folks, has done what they started the year talking about doing. They got the leadoff guy on base, and that's been a huge difference. In their 7 at-bats to this point, 5 times they got the leadoff guy on. 4 of those 5, they've scored in that inning.
They've done an outstanding job at that tonight. They've also done an outstanding job after scoring that leadoff guy of keeping rallies going, sustaining at-bats, and also just getting rid of what happened on Sunday. They've done a good job of that. You know, a lot of things could have happened tonight differently, but Texas came out tonight ready to play, and you can see that from the first inning on. They've done a very good job of pitching as well. Morgan Cooper pitching very well tonight, but the story has been the offensive side of the ball.
Nate Van Dyke will be the new pitcher, the sophomore from Montgomery. As the Bearcats go to the bullpen again, I think the tone was set. Obviously, we talk about the offense that led to the 10 runs, but Morgan Cooper, Greg, was really good tonight.
He had shut down stuff tonight. Six innings, a career high in strikeouts.
Van Dyke out of the stretch to Joe Baker. Joe's had a big night. 3 for 4. He's driven in a couple. Van Dyke steps to the third base side, pitches from the third base side of the rubber, really tries to get that right-handed hitter to give. You can see, watch his step. It'll come from Baker's back where he releases it, chopped on the ground. Third in time for the first out of the inning.
Talk about the job that Morgan Cooper did tonight. First inning on, had the good breaking ball going, had a good feel for it. Getting called strikeouts, and then the fastball came. Good velocity, good angle from Morgan Cooper. The most excited of the night was when he struck out.
Clemens comes up with the base hit. It's been a big night for a few folks. Barrera steps in. He's walked three times. And grounded to third, but he scored three times tonight. Very patient. Into left field for a base hit, 13th hit of the night for Texas. Barrera getting in on the action, staying back, short compact swing. Casey Clemens will step to the plate.
That was the big blow in the game.
At the time, it blew the game wide open.
Bases
no
loaded, Casey, with the double, three RBIs.
Casey, as Greg told you, 1 for 3 with 3 ribbies. I think tonight's game probably, if you watched it as we have from start to right now, it shows you how important strikes are and pitching ahead, pitching aggressively within the strike zone, early in counts especially. 2-0. It's been a ton of hitters counts for Texas hitters tonight where they really and truly can be aggressive on pitches they're looking for.
All night long.
Yep. Three-0 misses downstairs and a 4-pitch walk. We could have a pitching change here. Thirteen hits tonight for Texas, but the base runners, they've had them in every frame. Texas has not had a 1-2-3 inning offensively, other than the first, and it really wasn't a 1-2-3 inning. It was a double play ball that ended the first inning when they only sent three batters to the plate. And when you look at the upcoming schedule for Texas after tonight, travel out to California, Jackie Robinson Stadium. Play UCLA, has outstanding pitching. It's just, you look at their pitching staff. They're considered one of the better in the country, so that'll be a real test. And then a week from tonight, they travel to Texas A&M, play the Aggies, and then you have that stretch of home games. I think it's going to be a crucial time for this team, Greg. When you look at it, no question that Tulane's a good team. They're ranked in most polls around the country. Then you have UTSA coming in here on Tuesday. And then on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, because of Easter weekend, you have TCU coming to town to start conference play. And that's going to be your opportunity. You know, a lot of times TCU is picked by everybody throughout the country to win the conference. Well, you're going to play them early. So that's how important that first series will be.
Yeah, it's very important. And it's going to be a tough road test when you go on the road to play very good ranked teams like UCLA and Texas A&M. It's going to be so important for Texas when they get back here to play well at home. They have not played very well at home so far, so that'll be a good thing if they can do that when they return home.
First series matchup since 1989, and the first time it's ever been played at Jackie Robbins Stadium out in Los Angeles. So that'll be a fun series over the weekend and a great trip for the Longhorns. See if they can get something done.
New pitcher for Sam Houston is going to be Spence Ram. I've seen him on the playing first base and hitting home runs. He's been pitching a little bit for the Bearcats this year.
Can see he's making his fifth appearance. He has not issued an earned run. He's got his nice stirrups on. Old school stirrups right there. You don't see them very often. Sanitaries and stirrups. Makes you feel at home, doesn't it?
I like it.
Two and oh to Tate Shaw. In there for a strike, and it's 2-1.
Tate Shaw, the younger brother of Colin Shaw. Manned right field very well here for a few years.
It's in there for a strike, and the count evens at 2-2. Set. Just misses downstairs and the count goes full. Cody Clemens awaits on deck. Fought it off, keeps the at bat alive. Off of the fist. Didn't get an out. Everybody safe. Tried to tag the runner. Ball came out of the glove. McKnight trying to get an out. Was actually trying to get a double play.
He was trying to get Casey coming down the line. The ball gets in on Tate. If he gets there a second quicker, could have been some obstruction, but tried to make the tag as Casey went by and ball flips out of his glove. Everyone's safe.
Cody Clemens with a big night tonight. The 1-0. Good pitch there. Ram is that guy that they try to use as their closer. Like I said, making his fifth appearance. He has earned one save, averaging nearly two strikeouts
per appearance.
He's got a good size. He's got a live fastball, too.
Bearcats looking for a double play ball here. 1-2 to Cody Clemens. Got him with a breaking ball over the top of him. Two gone here now.
Those hanging breakers are so enticing. He's just rolling in there.
Well, there are times, though, when you, what happens to you is it's actually such a backup pitch that you take your head off of it. If it was a better breaking ball, you probably had a better chance to hit it. Brady Harlan steps in. He walked his last time up. Ripped into right. This could score a couple. Throw to the plate, not in time. 12-3 ball game. Brady Harlan with his first hit of the night.
A good fastball by Ram. This ball's down and in. Brady Harlan gets to it, lines it up in the right field.
Zane Gerwitz has had a big night. He's 3-for-4 tonight as he steps in. Scored twice, doubled. Driven in a run, scored a couple. The story of the night, though, Sam Houston State has been unable to get ahead in the ball game. They've been 1-0 or 2-0, it seems like, to every Texas batter. Count evens at 1-1. 14 hits now in the ball game for Texas. Fooled him off the end of the bat out to left. Smith puts it away, and that ends the inning. But not before Texas put another two spot on the board. We go to the ninth, 12-3 ball game. In the fourth inning, Cody Clemens, opposite field, two-run homer. One of three hits tonight. And now for our most dependable player of the game, powered by Chevy Silverado, it is Cody Clemens, 3-for-5, two-run homer. He's driven in three here tonight, as he is our most dependable player of the game, powered by Chevy Silverado. We go to the top of the night. You always hear that term, Greg, if you fall off a horse, what are you supposed to do?
You get right back on it.
And that's exactly what Skip Johnson's doing with his young right-hander.
Well, you want to get him right back out there, because the inning he had on Sunday is forgettable. Just go out there, forget about it, and now come out here tonight, get you a fresh inning. Hopefully a crisp inning. And then now you don't sit around for 10 days or a week before you have another opportunity to get back out on the mound.
Well, you see the numbers there. He was just brilliant in his first eight and the third innings of work. Really struggled on Sunday. Did not take the loss, but did give up 5 earned runs. So sugared into the game here. And he'll be facing the 5, 6, and 7 spots in the order. As Jordan Cannon will lead it off. I think this is a good idea. Yes, he threw quite a few pitches, but he's had yesterday totally off, and this is a mind change. This is about getting back, getting that taste out of your mouth and going forward.
That's one thing I appreciated head coaches, managers doing. When you did have a rough outing, a lot of times you can be put in the doghouse and not pitch for a while. Well, Chase is your closer. He's not going to sit for a while, but it is good for him to get back out there and get a feel for that pitch right there and get confidence going in to California against UCLA.
I think the key word for me, Greg, was confidence. Did you just get it back and go right back to where you were? Knee buckling breaking ball right here.
We've seen Chase all year. He's full of confidence. He's very knows his capabilities. But when you haven't been hit like that, probably in a long time.
Baird, 1-for-2 as he steps in.
In the back of your mind.
Base hit back up the box. Second hit of the night. So one out, base runner. And you try to learn from games that, like we saw on Sunday. And one of the things I think that Chase is learning, it's, you know, mentally, is his stuff's good, his velocity's good, but you still have to pitch down in the zone. When he elevates, guys are going to catch up to it. Breaking ball misses downstairs. Josh Biles steps in, fresh from Sugar Land. 1-for-3 as he steps in. He's got the big blow of the night for the Bearcats as he had a 2-run double. It's the last time up. You stay right there. That's location.
It's a very good location. It has a good angle, too. It's headed downhill. And also a real key for Chase is to get that breaking ball over.
Fastball. Got him swinging. Second strikeout of the inning.
So that ball has a downhill angle on it. Some run in to the hitter. Chris is outside, but this ball just runs down on the outer half of the plate. If you hit that, you're just going to pound it in the ground.
Jake Vasquez will be the pinch hitter. Freshman from League City. Fouls it back. Vasquez. A true freshman from Clear Springs High School. You see Barrera trying to tell him get that elbow up and get on top of the breaking ball. Longhorns an out away from securing the victory. Elbow. 1-1.
Elbow drops on a breaking ball. You lead with the elbow instead of leading with the hand. Tough to get on top of.
Figured working quicker. 1-2. Outside corner, strike 3 call, and that's the ball game. Chase Sugar comes in real quickly. That's the first thing I want to talk about is Chase Sugar getting him back on the mound.
Yeah, he got back out there, got the breaking ball over, threw strikes, got his confidence back. That's what the young freshman needed right there.
And when you look at the game tonight, one of the other things is they got the leadoff runner on base, and then they came up with hits with runners in scoring position. Two things that they really struggled over the weekend.
That's what we talked about in the opening, getting the leadoff guy on and keeping rallies going, getting base hits after extra base hits. That's what Texas did tonight. They did it very well. Got the walks, but also got hits with runners in scoring position and scored the runs.
All right, you look at what's taken place so far this season, Greg. A lot of home games, you've had one road trip where you won a game in extra inning. Now you're going to play two really good opponents in your next four ball games on the road. You can build momentum away from home, there's no question about it.
Well, you definitely can. You have to play good baseball. They saw this weekend what a top-ranked team plays like. Cal had a very good team. Texas has to go out to the West Coast and play UCLA and then come back and play Texas A&M. They have to play very good baseball. You know what a good team is now. Now you have to go out and prove that you can play with them.
Last thing is, the growth of Morgan Cooper. Do you feel like now at this point that he's probably mentally pushed through that fact that, hey, my arm and everything's going to stay together here? Because he really pitched exceptional baseball tonight.
He did. He went out tonight. I mean, he's so calm on the mound. He has such good stuff. The way they've brought him back, he went the 30 pitches. He went the 60 pitches. And tonight, 80 pitches. Next start could be 100 pitches. He's really bringing his rehab along good and pitching well.
Final score, Texas 12, Samuelson State 3. For all of us here at UFCU Dish Falk Field, we now leave you with the eyes of Texas.
Safe travels to your Longhorn team headed to California.